Google AdSense and my first salary in YouTube. So I finally received it on last Friday night. So it was transferred on February 25. And then merong ongoing pa yung February for payment for February. So hindi pa end yung February. So naka-appear lang dito is $12.64 centavos. So finally nakaabot ako or naka-receive ako ng salary unexpectedly kasi akaka-request ko lang din on February 24 I actually just requested a manual bid verification. So I have already a video about that. So this will just update on na-receive ko na yung payment or yung salary ko sa YouTube. So we can see here, it was already being transferred to my bank. And upon checking on last Friday, kasi nga dumating din yung sweldo ko on Connectis. So nag-appear din siya. So legit po yung YouTube. At I am very satisfied with the service or the support of Google AdSense. So we can see here that instead of $110 sana yung ma-claim ko, there is also a deduction. Probably this is from deduction for the tax. So this walang problem po sa akin yan that there will be a deduction for the tax. So that's also a way that you're also going to earn or to pay any government tax. So I'm planning to change the name of my channel because kasi last month or the first start of my YouTube are actually experimental kung saan talaga siya mag-work at how can I see na yung mga other YouTuber, yung mga sinishare nila are actually legit or not. So, wala masyado akong view lately on the premiere. So, with the help of the other groups, so nakita ko na I try also doing live asaka yung raw. Like, kinapost ko lang yung mga na-publish ko sa YouTube on my Facebook or to other Facebook group account. So, I see na mas malaki yung ang CPM niya. So, I'm going to show you what is CPM. Kung paano talaga mag-earn dito sa YouTube. So, based on also my observation as saka yung mga na-learn ko sa other YouTubers. So, let's go to my channel. So, ito yung analytics ko. So, you can see that here in revenue. So, you can choose here kung ilang days. So, yung default niya is 28 days. So, if I'm going to see on 90 days, ito yung mag-a-appear. So, kung 365 days, oops, something wrong. Bakit? Let's do refresh. Oh, this site can't be searched na. Huwag ka mag-lata. Okay. So, dito na lang muna tayo. So, ito yung highest ko na earning, yung 5-1 Talk low booking. Kasi at that time, na-notice ko from other 5-1 Talk teachers that there are a lot of 5-1 Talk teachers na nagpo-post ng mga videos sa YouTube. So, I started to be curious about YouTube because of the other 5-1 Talk teachers na marami silang nag-aspire to be a YouTuber. So, probably, I was thinking that time that how they are earning and how they actually be a potential for an extra income also that time. So hindi ako maka-focus at that time to do YouTube because I just give birth and then I'm also have a job, no? I thought na at that time na magsi-stay at home na lang ako and to work at 5-1 Talk. So I can see that in 5-1 Talk hindi siya stable. So, hindi rin siya good ang earning ko sa 5-1 Talk kasi there are a lot of teachers na mga we can see na they are mas matagal na sila at mas marami sila student. So, sa 5-1 talk then nagre-rely ka kung meron kang booking. So, if you don't have a booking, wala ka rin earnings. So, I can see na hindi siya stable talaga. Saka hindi siya makaka-help talaga sa mga needs ng family. So, I decided to go back to working sa office. So, few months later, is nagkaroon ng pandemic at they actually allow us to work at home. So, it's a blessing in disguise also. And then, when my husband decided also to buy a computer and also kompleto yung set na may microphone, then I was called to be a primary president. So, it inspired me to have a good content kasi I don't wanna just create a content out of nothing at all lang na basta-basta lang yung mga ginagawa ko na video. So, I wanted to create a content that would have a good interest to other people also and could actually help other people in terms kasi pag nag-YouTube ako, ang sinesearch ko yung ano yung if I want just to be something relaxing or something nakikurious ako about sa mga something any topics na maririnig natin o makikita natin sa social media. So, isi-search natin yun sa YouTube. So, most of the time, kailangan natin mag-create ng topic na that actually relevant and interesting. So, like this one sa 5-1 Talk Low Booking. At that time, maraming nagko-complain na teachers na naglulubooking sila. So, I was curious about it kung meron ba nag-post sa YouTube right that time about sa low booking. So, I noticed na wala. So, kaya nag-create ako on my own. And that was my first video that I created and posted on the YouTube. So, I see na nung pinost ko doon, I was not expecting too much that there will be a lot of views. So, a few days nakita ko na there were a lot meron na siyang mga 400. Then, hinayaan ko lang siya. Then, I find out, nung nag-check ulit ako ng matagal ng panahon na, that they actually viewed mga 3,000 hanggang sa ngayon, meron akong 4,000 views sa 5-1 Talk Blue Booking. So, it was a raw material. Hindi ko siya pinost sa Facebook ko. I just leave it here in YouTube. At marami siyang views because it's time relevant siya na topic kasi maraming nagko-complain na teachers sa 5-1 Talk kung bakit sila konti lang yung booking nila sa kanilang booking. So kaya ganun. So I notice here kung ito yung pinopost ko or yung pinopush ko talaga o pinapaboost ko na video na panoorin. So malaki yung kita ko. So 5-1 Talk Low Booking, ang color niya dito ay blue. So, we can see here na nung I just started to play this one or to boost this one noong January. Oh, no. Zero pa nga yan. So, kailan ba? Okay, January 20 lang. So, nakita ko na mas angat siya sa ibang video kung ito yung ibuboost ko talaga. So, I see here noong February 8. So, $16. So, I can see na ang ipo-focus talaga natin is yung CPM. So, as you see here, siya yung may highest na CPM. Ano ba yung playback-based CPM? So, effective cost per mile on the estimated average gross revenue per 1,000 playbacks on which an ad was shown, independent on which specific playback that advertiser was charged for. So, you can see na ito yung focus dapat natin, yung CPM, yung playback CPM. Kasi we can earn more through advertising, yung mga advertisement natin sa YouTube natin. So, this is the one you have to boost also. So, ito yung ifo-focus natin. And also, you have to create a content that is really interesting to the viewers. Sino yung need ng mga ganun na topic? So especially sa Paiwat Talk. So marami nag-YouTube how to get how to pass sa kanilang paano pumasa sa kanilang ano yung demo. Yon, yung demo nila. So meron maraming tutorial how to pass the demo of Paiwan Talk, ano yung mga benefits, ano yung mga disadvantages. So maraming manunood na yan na who are aspiring to join the family of Paiwan Talk. So yun, so maraming manunood. So yung mga topic na maganda at saka yung interesting din. So it could be your life na somehow nakikita mo na and makakaroon din ng interest yung ibang tao na manood. So raw materials dapat yung i-focus natin. So for me, hindi na talaga effective yung mga premiere by group kasi na-notice ko talaga yung mga pinapa-play ko through premiere, maliit lang talaga yung playback CPM. So as you see, kaysa yung mga raw talaga na pinost ko. So itong primary service raw din ito siya. Hindi ko siya pinost sa group premieres. So you see, malaki yung CPM niya din. Pati yung live ko nung primary class nung January 9. So 183 din yung playback CPM niya. So kahit konti lang yung view, compare sa view ko nung group na premiere, so mas malaki pa yung CPM niya. So I'm planning to shift my channel something that are more interesting sa more viewers kasi yung topic ko more on gospel. So I'm going to mix it something tutorial din at saka yung mga any topic that can actually yung isi-search ng mga mag-YouTube or manonood like tutorial. Ano ba yung experience mo as a mother o experience mo as a father o yung experience mo how to get a job. So, anything that can help other people or would actually make them search on YouTube. Kasi pag sinerch niyan at ikaw yung makita niya na nag-post niyan and if he's going to watch that, it means also na it's actually yun yung way na maglalaki yung CPM mo din. So ano pa yung lumaki na CPM ko? Mostly yung mga live ko talaga. So as you see. So yung work from home, it is only 5 minutes. So hindi siya live, pinost ko lang talaga siya at pinost ko din siya sa Facebook. So it has also a high CPM. So malaki siya. So kung ito yung focus natin, then it is really much better. So, as you see, nang start ako ng November na ma-monetize siya. So, actually, I only reached $10. Then, nung December, mas lumaki siya. Of course, kasi yung November, hindi man siya at the start of the month. So, yung December, hindi din siya ganun kalaki. It only reached for $37, which is hindi siya nakaabot ng threshold. Noong January, maliit pa rin, $62. So as you see, in February, I already learned the techniques. So I already reached 271.12 centavos. So as you see, nag-grow yung channel ko, yung revenue ko. I mean, yung revenue ko. So, konti pa lang yung subscriber ko. At I have a lot of videos. So, I will keep this video. But I'm going to create a content that is more catchy. And more people will have interest on watching it. So, nakita ko na mas maganda yung raw talaga. So, unlike sa mga premiere by group. So, siguro na didetect ito ni YouTube that you are actually doing yung team up. So, yan. So, kung magla-live ka, much better siguro may you have some other people that will help you also to watch on your live videos. Yeah. Kaysa yung premiere talaga na recorded siya tapos ipi-play mo at Spike. May playlist kasi at meron yun siguro dahilan bakit nadidetect ni YouTube at maliit lang yung binibigay niya na CPM. Pero kung gusto mo siya palakihin, i-boost mo lang siya ng i-boost. Pero unlikely kasi pag raw siya, automatic siya na malaki yung CPM or natsatsambahan siya. Tulad nito. So ito, it just only 2 minutes. Diba? So malaki din compared talaga sa mga pinipremiere ko na by group. So yan. So, I'm gonna create more and I'm gonna think more about how to make this channel grow by creating more videos that are more interesting at more yung mga i-search talaga ng mga tao magpi-play sa YouTube. So, that's all for now and I hope that this actually yung video ko na ngayon ay makakatulong at will give you an idea how to make to improve your channel para mag-improve ka na mag-create ng YouTube or yung mga content that actually that are more interesting to the viewers. And also, what are the videos that you have to focus in boosting? So, maraming ways to boost your channel or your videos. If you want to know more, so you can actually leave a comment here or send me a personal message to my Facebook or Messenger. That's the way I can help you guys. Kasi ayoko din na madetect ako dito at iniingatan ko din yung channel ko. So, that's all for now. And I hope that you continue to support this channel by subscribing. And I will share more on how to help you in growing your channel. And also, what are the things that I think na nakahelp sa buhay ko at nakahelp na mag-progress sa buhay ko and for my family and for our future plan. So that's all and thank you so much and God bless and see you soon.